So, you know, till about 2009-10, when the foundation was set up, you know, prior to that, we actually, you know, were working more through independent NGOs. So we had a lot of NGO partners who were assisting us in like getting, you know, our CSR programs executed. But somewhere around 2009, we realized that, you know, our program would expand and, you know, we'll get into more geographies, the coverage of program would increase. And then, you know, we felt the need of setting up a separate institution, you know, which could take care of our work at that scale in future. And that's why the foundation came into being. It also gave us an opportunity to have a direct connect with the community partners, you know, with whom you know, we were implementing these projects. That was also a reason behind our setting up the foundation at that point in time. Incidentally, it gave us another opportunity in terms of networking. Mm-hmm. So we started to partner more conveniently with government, with other corporates, with NGOs, with community-based organizations. So these were some of the advantages that we felt we could leverage, you know, if we set up our own foundation, and that's why we thought of doing it in 2009. So I'll come to the second part of the question first, the model of implementation. So like I mentioned in my earlier response, we were implementing most of our projects through the NGO partners. And we felt that, you know, we were not able to get that direct connect with the communities who were the stakeholding communities with us. So as a model, what we have adopted now is that we have built the capacity of our foundation to be our group's CSR implementing partner. So most of our projects are now implemented through our foundation. Of course, we continue to have partnerships with other NGOs, with governments, and, you know, with other institutions, but majority of our programs are now being handled by our foundation. In terms of the priorities that we have chosen to work on, you know, it comes from our business's ecological footprints. We are majorly into two businesses, cement and sugar. And both of these businesses have some ecological footprints. We share air, we share water with communities, you know, in which we operate. And we feel it is our responsibility to, you know, give back those resources to the communities. Having said that, our priorities are water, access to clean energy, and skilling people for livelihood. So these are the three areas in which we work. And across our 17 active locations as of now, we work, you know, on one or the other of these issues depending on the geographical priorities. As the company grew, as the group started to set up more businesses, the greenfield projects, as well as acquiring, you know, some other companies, the CSR also started to spread. And like I said, we kind of sensed this in 2009, and that was the reason of setting up a foundation, because we wanted to create an institution which could handle the work at that scale. And so it grew slowly, organically, from 3-4 active locations at that time. Currently we are at 17 active locations, and almost all over the country. We began with south and with one location in UP in the north. You know, currently we have a good presence in east, in the states of Orissa, Jharkhand and West Bengal. We have a very good presence in northeast, in the states of Assam and Meghalaya. We have also expanded our work to Rajasthan now, and to some parts of Maharashtra. So it has been a quick but still an organic growth for the foundation in all these years. So like I mentioned, you know, our focus shifts between three areas. One is water, one is access to clean energy, and one is skilling people for livelihood. On water, you know, our focus is on conservation of water and, you know, using that for improvement of agriculture. We have been doing it at almost all of our locations. The simple philosophy is that, you know, the quantity of fresh water that we take from the aquifers there. We want to recharge those aquifers with larger quantities of water. We take up a holistic approach while doing that. So watershed management is one of our preferred designs of the program, and we co-fund some very large watershed projects with NABARD. Currently we are working in about 8500 hectares of land and developing that on watershed basis. As per our current estimates, we have already created a water harvesting capacity of about 4 million meter cubes. Many of our plants are water positive by way of this program. There is a large area that we have brought under micro irrigation. On access to clean energy, it all started with our realizing that people close to our plants were burning wood in their kitchens, and these were closed kitchens with no outlets. And they were inhaling tons of emissions. So we wanted them to convert to or shift to the cleaner sources of energy. And we started to help them use the fuel efficient cook stoves, biogas plants. And off late, we have also started to help them procure the LPG connections and then be using the LPG. Then we realized that they also continued to burn a lot of kerosene for lighting purpose, and the power supply, even though the villages were connected, the power supply was erratic. So we helped them convert to solar power, start using more of that in the form of home lighting systems or solar lanterns or solar study lamps. These small pretty cheap equipments actually add a lot of value to the quality of lives of the people in these villages. We are helping the community reduce an emission of about 20,000 tons of CO2 every year by way of using these equipment. On skilling, we have partnered with NSDC, National Skill Development Corporation, and we are aiming at skill training about 1 lakh youth in the next 8 to 10 years. But it's not just about training them, it's also about helping them find suitable wage or self-employment. In the process, we have also started to partner with various state governments through their state skill missions. Orissa, for instance, we are working very closely with them and again helping them train the youth in Orissa. So that's the focus on skilling. No, I think we have always believed in collaborations, because we firmly believe that with our limited resources, there will be a limit to the kind of impact that we can bring. And if there are other organizations who have similar goals and objectives, it's always good to partner. So we have always been open to these partnerships. We currently partnered with several corporations, other private sector companies like HP, Shell, and Schneider. So these are some of the companies with whom we have partnered, and we are doing some projects together, and we sincerely believe that this partnership has brought in a lot of value to our work. We partner extensively with the governments. NABARD is one of our larger partners. We work with almost all state governments through the line departments in all the states where we have our operations, be it in south, be it in east, be it in northeast, or be it in UP. But I think we have always admired these partnerships, and these partnerships have certainly brought a lot of value to our program, and our programs are more impactful, I think, because of these partnerships. We seem to have crossed that phase where we faced these challenges. One usually faces those both internally and externally during the initial years, because you have very large number of stakeholders, and then you have to bring all of them on one platform. When you decide that you will be focused on a few issues and not spread yourself thin, then managing very large number of both internal and external stakeholders is always a challenge. As of now, I think whatever fresh challenges come at the new locations that we pick up for our operations. Otherwise, the things are going pretty smooth for us. So when And if we map our stakeholders, our employees or our colleagues in the organization are one of our important stakeholders, you know, because the organization takes pride in what we do through our CSR. And we have always been getting these feelers from our employees that they wanted to get more involved in our work. For those who are at the plant locations where we have the CSR programs, it's easier for them to get involved. But it's slightly difficult for our colleagues in the head offices or the regional offices to, you know, get directly involved in our programs. We thought we'll bring some structure to, you know, give them, you know, a channel or a platform, you know, to get involved in CSR. And that's where we started to, that's where we conceived this program called Roshni along with our HR. Roshni gives an employee, every employee, opportunity to go out and volunteer for a cause at least for 2 days in a year. There are instances when some of our colleagues have chosen to, you know, spend more time on their cause. So two working days, or, you know, to put it in other ways, about 16 hours are officially allowed. Then one can, on request, spend more time, and one can, of course, can spend one's personal time with these organizations and on these causes.